Morning, boys and girls. It's Sunday school, and this is the 8th week of online Sunday school and assemblies. And we're going to sing 4 songs today, and today we're going to finish off talking about our animals. And today we're going to talk about an insect, a spider, and then finish about talking about a deer. And I've got a wee pet deer I want to show you later on, all right? Let's sing the Sunday song, Light of the World. Don't forget to do the actions.
The world is searching for an answer.
Singing about the light of the world. We're here this morning, Sunday school, to worship the Lord, and let's do that. Stand up if it helps you sing any better, folks. Ready? Light of the world, the Lord Jesus.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see. Yeah.
So another lovely worship song. Now we're going to sing the butterfly song. How God made these little creatures. And let's sing it. You little ones should know the actions for this. Enjoying really good weather recently, and we can see the handiwork of God at the springtime with the animals, with the fields, the flowers, everything's changing. Springtime into summer is a beautiful time. But before we come to today's story, we're going to finish off talking about the animals. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we just thank you so much for Sunday school again. We thank you for all the boys and girls, and pray, Lord, you'll help me to tell this story now and help us to learn so much about you. In your loving name we pray. Amen. So, as you can see, we've got a new screen. We've been saving our pennies together, putting them together, because we want to try and make our presentation for Sunday school and assemblies as clear as possible. And you can see this beautiful, we're going to refer back to this, and you'll all agree this is a beautiful horse, a beautiful creature, with its shininess, its stature, and even the sheep. We were talking about horses, we were talking about sheep, and the rainbow, of course, reminding us of the NHS and how we should be so thankful for these people working in the front line trying to save people's lives. We talk about sheep, and how the Lord Jesus said he's the good shepherd who giveth his life for the sheep, and we are the sheep, and he's the one who gave his life for us. Then we talked about the little lambs, and sometimes sheep can be a wee bit cheeky and stick out their tongue when you want to get a photograph, but of course the wee lambs. And even the wee lamb, the Lord Jesus, is a picture, because he told us, John the Baptist said, Jesus is a Lamb of God which taketh away the sin of the world. Just like a little lamb is innocent, it's so beautiful. The Lord Jesus, so beautiful, so innocent, yet he laid down his life for me and for you. So there is the little lamb. And then, of course, we talked about donkeys in the Bible. The Bible's full of animals. And in the book of Numbers, three chapters, covers the story of the original talking donkey. And of course, this man, he tried to go into the middle of the night to curse people to get money. The donkey began to beat the donkey. Because the donkey stopped walking, crushed his foot against the wall. The donkey saw the angel, and Balaam didn't. And as a result, he beat the donkey almost to death. He was so cruel. And yet, because this king, he wanted to curse the people, he tried to pay him with money, and the donkey says, no, you're not going to do that because it's wrong. Imagine a donkey teaching a man the difference between right and wrong. And then we talked about the raven. Now, how come this is a beautiful, shiny black bird? We all love the shiny black horse. But if I was to say to you, what about this shiny black bird? You would say, no. Why is that? Do birds have ears? You can't see them. Yet when they speak, you speak, they can hear you. You clap your hands, they fly off. These are the birds God spoke to. And to feed his friend Elijah. A famine, no rain for 3.5 years. For 2 of those years, every morning, every night, the blackbirds, the ravens, bring Elijah bread and meat as he sat by the brook Cherith behind the tree. Yet these birds were the ones that God used. And he didn't use the eagles or the sparrows or the robins, the birds we would think he might have. No, he used the most despised birds, the birds we would not imagine God using. And sometimes you might think or not even imagine God using you. God could use you, boys and girls, if you're willing to be used by him and let your life, let God use your life. He can and he will. And that's why when you're young, it's good to get familiar with the Bible so that you can start telling people all about it. And these are the bears. We talked about the bears when David chased, killed a bear for killing a sheep. And then, of course, Elisha. These children, 42 of them, were mocking him. And he said, stop mocking, making fun of me. But they never stopped, and the two big female bears come out and chased him in the forest. Yes, read that in the Bible as well. Then the lions, whenever Daniel was in the den of lions, God spoke to these monsters, the king of the jungle. Many of them, don't touch my friend Daniel. And these animals, they listened to God. And they closed their mouths. And they never touched Daniel. And then we talked about how the devil's like a roaring lion going about seeking whom he might devour. In other words, distract or to take away from God. That's his purpose in life, to distract your attention from thinking about God and giving your heart to God. So boys and girls, who are we going to follow today? Is it the devil, or are we going to follow God? That's a challenge in life. And then we talked about the camels. And this was Rebecca. And this man, he was going to find a wife for Abraham's son Isaac. And he said, Lord, the first woman who offers to give my camels water to drink will be the wife for Isaac. And he asked this girl for a drink of water. And she said, do you mind if I carry water for your 10 camels? He couldn't believe it. And that was the wife for Isaac. Read that in the Bible. Then the Lord Jesus and Peter come into the city. They needed to pay tax. They had no money. Jesus says to Peter, go and fish. And he casts his rod into the water, into the sea. And God speaks to a wee fish in the bottom and says, pick up that coin on the bottom of the ocean and swim to the top, grab onto the hook. And out it came with the coin. And that was enough to pay for the tax. Miracle after miracle. And then we go from a little fish that God spoke to, and then we go to a big fish. And all these animals obedient to the voice of God. Boys and girls, here's Jonah. And he's thrown into the depth of the sea to perish. But the Bible says God prepared a great big fish. And it swallowed up Jonah. 3 days and 3 nights he's in the belly of the whale. And he says, Lord, I'm sorry. I will do what you've asked me to do. And off he goes to Nineveh. Did you know, boys and girls, after he told all the people of Nineveh to repent, to turn from their sin, they'd done that? And Jonah was upset. And God said, Jonah, why are you upset? Jonah never loved the people, but God did. And God said, Jonah, what about the thousands of little ones who don't know the difference between their left and their right? Children. God loved them and he spared them. And he said, not only the children, what about the animals? Read that in the 4th chapter of Jonah, when God says about the animals. God loves the animals. He made the animals. Yes. And then when we finished off talking about insects, and we talked about the ant and the locust and the spiders. And we're challenged to learn from the ants. Yes, they are a people, they're not strong. You can squash an ant like this. Yet they prepare their meat in the summer for the winter. They're good workers, they're not lazy, they're always working. And the locusts, they have no king to guide them. Yet they fly in their thousands, they go in the one direction, they work together. And the spider, they took hold with their hands in the king's palace. Amazing. What does that say about the ant? They're not lazy. Boys and girls in your childhood, don't be lazy. Learn to work with your mind and your hands and your feet. Help with the chores at home. In your school time, learn as much as you can. Don't be idle. Don't waste your days. The best time in life is primary school age, when you're preparing for your future life, mentally, physically, spiritually, especially preparing your heart for God. And that's the best time to get to know the book, when your mind is so fresh and learning and your heart is so receptive. You see, laziness is a great enemy of a good work ethic. See, every time you go to read, you'll be tempted to play or to watch the computer or go onto the phone, and you'll be distracted day after day, and your life will just pass, and you could have learned so much, but you didn't take the opportunity. Then these are wee lizards. God made these little creatures. These are not big. These are the size of your wee finger, sometimes bigger. Yet look at the detail. God made these creatures. Amazing. And these animals can change the colour of their skin to adapt their surroundings. If they're in a green tree, they'll turn green. If they're in a red brick wall, they'll turn red. And you can see these scampering up the wall, across the ceiling. I can't walk on a ceiling, no chance. I would fall. Yet, boys and girls, they can. Yes. And what are they waiting for? We're learning about patience. Here's this wee insect, or this wee lizard, waiting in insects, and it'll wait and wait for maybe hours until a fly comes. Just like that. That's the size of them. That's a wee baby one. Look at the details in the claws. Yet they can walk on a ceiling without falling, even whenever they get heavier, and they're waiting and waiting. I struggle with patience. Yes, ask Joanna. And yet, these wee lizards are so patient, waiting and waiting and watching. Then the spider. You might not like spiders. I'm not too fond of them either, but they're fascinating little creatures. The Bible tells us in Genesis how God created the great sea, living creatures, the monsters that move within the waters, and they're a kind of winged bird. And God saw that it was good. God created all these creatures in the air, the birds, the fish, the animals. God was really pleased with it. But look at what a spider does. It creates a web, spins a web. Could you do that? Yet a wee spider, so much detail in a spider's web. Yet if you ever walk into a shed after a few days, your face is covered with spider's web, you get so cross, where's that spider? And you go in the next day, what's happened? The spider web's back again. Look at the detail. A wee spider that size of your fingernail can create all this web. Why? Just to catch a spider, just to catch a fly, and it will wait day and night until the fly comes. See, when a fly catches that, no mercy. The spider's on like a rocket. It can walk on it. See, that's the centre. It all comes out from the centre. You see, boys and girls, the detail is unbelievable. Look, there's a spider busy spinning its web in absolute perfection, going to catch the wee fly. And we're going to finish off talking about a deer. Look, we're going to sing this song at the end as well. And here's the deer, panting, thirsting, wanting to taste the waters. And what's the lesson, boys and girls? To me, the still water reminds me of God's word. You see, without the water, the deer will die. It's thirsting, it's longing. I wonder today, as we think of the wee deer looking in the water, how much do we need God's word? How much do we rely on it to have our thirst quenched every day? Yes, we all drink water. Water is important, absolutely essential. But for the soul and the heart and the mind, we need God's word as well. Do you know I have a wee pet deer? I'm going to show you my wee pet deer. Okay? Small one, maybe small. Come on over, bring wee pet deer. Go take her. Ha ha! That's my wee pet deer.
Hello.
Joanna. Yes, spelt differently. This is a D-E-A-R. That's a D-E-E-E. Deer. Yes, the animal. And this is Joanna, my wife. She's the one behind the scenes. I'm looking at you, and you're looking at me, but I'm looking beyond you, and I can see Joanna. That's what we're doing. So she, the same as behind every good man, is an even better woman. And this is absolutely true in my case. Joanna comes from Poland. Not only do we create assemblies for children and Sunday school, but we also create movies for children in Poland so they can learn from the Bible as well. And it's an absolute honour and privilege. We normally travel to Poland 4 or 5 times a year. That's been halted, so we're still trying to reach them. So I'm going to show you how that works. Okay, I'm going to speak Polish. My eyes are about to piękne, herbata tak. That's all I know. Just said my wife is very beautiful, gives me a cup of tea, breakfast food, all those things included. But this is how it works, for example. Good morning, I'm in Poland. This is me talking in Poland, and this is Joanna translating. Good morning, boys and girls.
Dzień dobry, chłopcy i dziewczyny.
My name is Colin, this is Asia.
Mam na imię Colin, this is Asia.
And we're going to talk about animals in the Bible.
Będziemy rozmawiać dzisiaj o zwierzętach w Biblii.
The Bible is a wonderful book.
Biblia jest fantastyczną książką.
We love to share it with the boys and girls.
Lubimy się dzielić nią z chłopcami i dziewczynkami.
You see how it works? And then they can hear the gospel, and many children and young people have trusted the Lord Jesus over all those years. All right? So this is Joanna. She needs to be right behind. Okay. To keep it all moving. So ciao. Bye for now.
Bye.
Got a cup of tea in a wee minute. Thank you. Okay, let's finish off with the deer. It's a lovely picture of the animal. What else does the Bible say? The deer walks in the high places. Yes, because of their hooves, the way they walk, and you can see them in the winter, in the snow. They've got their hind legs. It talks about the deer, and there's the beautiful antlers, the beautiful creature. You can often see them in the distance. And what else does it say? Who is God? Save the Lord. Or he is a rock, save our God. He's the one that girdeth me with strength, maketh my ways perfect. He maketh my feet like hinds' feet, and setteth me upon the high places. What's he talking about? The deer. When you see this here, we're talking about the deer. And there's, could you imagine walking in this cliff? This is a huge rock. And yet the Bible talks and even knows about the deer. The Lord knows about the deer on the cliff edge. We talked about just like the deer needs the water, the still waters, the calm waters. And that's what we need for refreshment every single day. And yet, whenever these wee hooves are on the rock, it's in a sure place. It's gripped. It's confident. And the moment a lion comes or an animal comes, that little deer can bolt across that rock like you can run up the stairs or run across your garden. And yet the way these little feet can climb on the rock. And yet that rock reminds me of the Lord Jesus. And just like the wee deer can be on the rock and feel safe on the rock, we can be safe with the rock. And I'm talking about the rock, Christ Jesus. He is a solid rock. He is my foundation. He is my Saviour and my God. So I need to drink the water. I need the Word of God, the water of life. And I also need the rock every day to lean on, to hold on to. And without the rock, I have nothing. I am nothing. And without the water, without the Word of God, I will dry up spiritually. So both of these in my life are absolutely important. Even with the insect, the spider, we're encouraged not to be lazy, like the ant not to be lazy, and like the spider to be patient, and like the deer, hold on to the rock and be sure and be confident with every single step, because you're staying close to the rock, drinking the still waters, the Word of life, the Word of God, staying to the rock. Boys and girls, don't miss out with the rock Christ Jesus. Now, so as we think about the still waters and the rock and the deer, so many lessons from the animal. I'm going to sing that song now, as the deer pants for the waters. Okay, let's sing that song, folks, as the deer pants for the waters. Ready? Ready?
As the deer pants for the waters. You alone are my strength.
enjoyed Sunday school today. We're back tomorrow, Wednesday, Friday, 11 o'clock for the assembly. And we'll really look forward. Don't forget, tomorrow we've got those special pictures of birthday children. So let's all pray. Father, we just thank you for Sunday school today, for these lovely songs of worship, thinking about the Lord Jesus and the lessons we can draw from the insects and from the animals in the Bible. We pray for all the boys and girls. We pray, Lord, young in life will come and put their faith and trust in the Lord Jesus and ask you to save them so they can live their lives for you. In your lovely name we pray. Amen. See you tomorrow.